HTC does an outstanding job in sales for the month of May. New market studies show the top players in the smartphone business. And have you broken your iPhone's display lately? Because Apple will fix it, but for a tax. I'm Jaime Rivera, and I'd be willing to pay top dollar for home delivery of coffee. This is Pocket Now Daily. Let's start today off with the product releases. Toshiba has brought us three new Excite tablets. Even though they've never been able to excite any of us to buy any of these tablets in the past. But these three models are kind of interesting. They run Android 4.2.2, and one of them even has stylus recognition. So links down below for the full description of each of these products for you to probably ignore anyway. Intel has been another company that has not really succeeded in the mobile space, but they're still trying, and they've got two new processors for the mobile business. One being the Merrifield processor for smartphones and the Bay Trial T. I'm not kidding, that's the name, Bay Trial T for tablets, being unique in its own way. And well, how serious is Intel lately when it comes to mobile devices? Well, the Samsung Galaxy Tab 3 10.1, and I know the name is a mouthful, is now running an Intel Atom processor, even though they make their own processors at Samsung. So it could be that things might be getting good for Intel. Let's see. Now let's talk about the smartphone market. Kantar has now released their quarter trends, and as it turns out, Android still remains supreme at 52% of the smartphone market. Then we've got iOS at 42%, which is actually growing in comparison to the same period last year. And then we've got Windows Phone that's actually grown into 5% from a 4%, which is actually great. Sad news for BlackBerry, as it's dropped all the way down to 0.7% from a 4% last year. So who are you cheering for here? Leave us a comment. Moving over to HTC, the company grew 26% in revenue after the launch of the HTC One in the month of April, but May has proven to be much better with a 48% growth in revenue, which is outstanding. 5 million units of the HTC One have apparently been sold, even though we haven't really been able to confirm this, but the sad news is that they've now raised the price of the HTC One to match the Google edition of the same phone, which is rather unfortunate, but we don't blame them. I mean, if the phone has actually proven to be a success, then yeah, demand, that's the way it works. And finally, for the sort of interesting news of the day, Apple is now replacing broken displays of iPhones in their Genius Bar at any Apple store, which is both good and bad. It's good because, well, for $150, they'll do everything for you right there, which is close to the price of a display on eBay that's not necessarily official or genuine. But the bad part is that in the past, for $200, they gave you a brand new phone right there instead of just replacing the cracked display. And I still don't know if they keep the policy of the $200 for a new phone, but if you think about it, it's kind of a deal for many people that just don't want to do things themselves. And if you consider how much it costs you to replace a display on any Samsung Galaxy smartphone, which is like $250 to $300 just for the display, and then you do it yourself, well, this is kind of a deal. But that leads me to the question of the day. How much have you paid to replace a broken display? In my particular case, well, I've paid the Apple tax. I've paid the $200 and they've given me a brand new phone. But leave us a comment down below. What have you done whenever you've broken a device or broken a display? And of course, for another scoop of everything that's happening in the smartphone and tablet world, make sure you follow us on PocketNow.com, subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. You can also follow me on Twitter at Jaime_Rivera. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I am Jaime Rivera. Thank you very much for watching. We will see you tomorrow.